This is a preliminary set of details about the webinar. I'm Peter Cooper. Rhonda Morris is going to be presenting this, and she'll be on in just a minute. Any questions we get with their answers will be available after the webinar. They'll be linked to our webinars page. They will also be in the materials directory on the FDP site. That shortcut link there, go.usa.gov/xn-z2b, will get you there. So with that, I'm going to turn this over to Rhonda.
Hi, guys. Thank you for joining us today. Today's talk will be about keeping current and getting help with NCBI resources. In this short webinar, you'll learn several ways that can help you keep up to date with changes and updates that are happening at NCBI on our website and with our data, and also where to look and ways to find help using NCBI resources. As a U.S. government agency and part of the National Library of Medicine, we are always keep in mind that we're here to serve you. We have a specific mission to perform computational and data analysis research, gather data from all over the globe, create systems to enable you to access and use our data, and help you figure out how to use it. As part of this mission, we're not only putting on this webinar today, but have created various mechanisms to communicate with you about all the cool things going on here at NCBI and help you learn how to use them, and also provide help in helping you use them. Just to recap about what you may already know, we've got lots and lots of databases with lots of different kinds of data. Currently, there are over 40 different databases available on the NCBI website. We also create lots of tools to help you access and analyze the data in those databases. We're updating existing and creating new resources all the time. Within those databases are a huge amount of data, which is constantly being added to. Some of these databases are updated every day, and some are updated regularly, such as GenBank, with specific periodic releases. For those of you who have visited our website over the years, you may have noticed that some of our pages still look similar to how they did when they were first released. We are in the process of updating our pages to provide an easier to read and use layout of our data. This is a new initiative at NCBI, and you'll see some major changes coming up in the next couple of years. For example, for the DB SNP pages, which have been around for over a decade, we're now testing out a new design, which we hope will help SNP users find what they are looking for more easily and quickly. We have a feedback button, that's the green button on the side over here, and would really like to hear what you think about these pages, what you like and what works well for you, as well as what you think we might change to make it even better. In addition to creating better web pages for you, we're also looking at what is under the hood to improve what you see back after you do a search. An example here is the new PubMed Labs project, which is testing a new search algorithm to improve how literature results are found. In the process, we're also testing out new modern displays and even adding cool new functionality with it. PubMed Labs is a sandbox to test all this out, and the things that we find here are going to be really good and helpful, and the ones that people like and can use will eventually add to improve to the regular PubMed interfaces. So we're trying cool new stuff all the time. This is a lot of stuff, and a lot of stuff going on at NCBI. New data every day, updated functionality, updated web page layouts, new resources, and cool new things coming online all the time. How can you keep up with it all? We've got a lot of channels to help you with this. There are many ways to find out what's new at NCBI, and many different tutorial and help documents designed to help you learn how to use our resources. We even have put online very recently a new NCBI support center designed to help you find answers to your questions and to assist in sending messages to our help desk to get your specific questions answered. Don't worry about all these icons for now. We'll go through them all. I also have a cheat sheet at the end of this presentation, which summarizes pretty succinctly everything that you need to know. And we'll tell you how to get a copy of this cheat sheet for yourself. So, amongst the vastness of the NCBI website, where is a good place to start to learn about what's new at NCBI? Here's the NCBI homepage. I'll show you how to access a lot of the things from a single page. I'm going to recommend that you start at the NCBI Learn site, which will connect you to everything we'll talk about today pretty much on a single page. Click on the Learn to get to this Learn page. You may have seen this page before, but if you haven't, it's pretty worthwhile. This is where we announce all of our NCBI Minute webinars, like the one that you're looking at today. Click on the Webinars and Courses box, and it'll take you to a list of teaching events about what we're doing. Here's the webinar that you're in today, and here's where you did or you could have registered to participate. While most of you probably heard about this webinar on Twitter or Facebook, there's a reason to come to this webinars and courses page. Here is where we put links to all the materials for the webinar as soon as it's been done. We'll put up the PowerPoint slides that you're actually seeing, a Q&A document answering questions you may have that we haven't had time to cover live. And for this particular webinar, I've got a cheat sheet in there that I mentioned and I'm going to tell you about later on. Finally, we'll also put a link to the video made of this webinar that we'll put up on YouTube in a few days. While many of you may just want to watch the video on YouTube, I know several of you might like the PowerPoints from our webinar presentations to use either to update yourself or to use with your colleagues. Back to the main Learn page, on the right-hand side, you may notice something that looks a lot like what was on the main NCBI homepage also, an NCBI news and blog section with titles and links. This is indeed the same, and we also have another place where you can get to our NCBI Insights blog on the bottom. Here's where we make major and minor announcements, provide some answers and how-tos for frequently asked questions, and basically let people know what's going on here at NCBI and on our website. For example, last week we did another one of these NCBI Minute webinars to let people who write scripts and code know about a new tool, an API key, that we're making available to help them better access our servers. This is a WordPress-style blog, so if you have a WordPress account, you can set up to get email alerts or an RSS feed information about how the new posts that come out. We've also created several other social media accounts and linked them here to provide this information if you don't have a WordPress account or prefer to use Twitter or Facebook or LinkedIn instead. You don't have to go through the NCBI Insights blog to get to our social media accounts. Back on our Learn page again, we've got two different spots where you can get to our feeds, channels, or sites for your favorite social media platforms. You're welcome to sign up to follow us on any of these social media sites, Twitter, Facebook, and LinkedIn, where we even have showcase pages where we segregate notifications into those pertinent areas of genomes, genes, proteins, chemicals, literature, and health-related subjects. Keep in mind that everything that goes out on the NCBI Insights blog is also announced on each of these other social media platforms, so you don't need to worry that you'll miss anything. You can just pick one that you're most comfortable with, and it'll be able to let you know what's going on. We also have an NCBI announced email listserv for those people who would prefer to be notified in their email inbox. We also have an NCBI announced RSS feed for people using that mode. Just to let you know, though, while we often announce our participation in various scientific and clinical conferences on all of our social media sites, sometimes we'll tweet more about it to let those people who are attending know and also include hashtags for the event. But for the most part, you won't miss any of our news or announcements regardless of whichever social media site you prefer to use. You certainly don't need to follow them all. Now you've found out how to be notified of goings-on at NCBI, news and other announcements. But how can you figure out how to use the cool new things you've learned about? Back on the NCBI Learn page, first there are those webinars, like the one coming up. There is one coming up about Quick Blast P. Hint, hint, you might want to sign up for it. And the blog. Sometimes we have posts showing you how to find gene symbols and all their aliases or how to use the genome data viewer, for example. But we also have written and video tutorials as well as help documents to help you figure out how to do something. We also try to fully use our YouTube channel, not just to show these short webinars, but we also have short 1 to 3 minute videos showing you how to do something very specific on our site as well. We have a lot of different videos and even a lot of different playlists here. Many of these are actually linked directly from our pages to provide help. Others are often viewed after a simple web search to find a helpful video. For very specific help using a particular resource, let's say a database or a tool, we recommend that you look at the actual homepage for that resource. The developers for those resources will often put helpful links on the left-hand side of the page to assist you in learning how to use their baby. Most of the time on our site, there's also a help link in the upper right-hand corner of the page, which will help take you to the main help documentation for that page or that particular resource. Here's the gene database homepage, which has those help links on the left and some quick search terms at the bottom. And it also has that main help link in the upper right-hand corner, just like PubMed did. Our BLAST homepage also has a help link in the upper right, both on the homepage, and it's still there when you go to any particular BLAST page as well. More complex tools have their own documentation, sometimes as simple help and sometimes more. Here's a picture of the variation viewer, which in the, again, upper right-hand corner has help and also an FAQs link to answer frequently asked questions. But it also has a direct link to helpful videos on our YouTube channel as well. Those links that were on the left-hand side of the home pages, they often go to help manuals and FAQ chapters on our NCBI bookshelf. There's a lot of help there that you can either get to from a particular resource, or you can go to the book's database and do a search. We really recommend the NCBI Handbook, which has chapters for each major database and tool and describes pretty technical aspects of the resources like scope, history, where the data comes from, how to access it, and related tools and resources. But for more specific and practical help with how to use a resource, there are a lot of different help manuals which were designed just to do that, to show you how to use the resource practically. Finally, if you need specific help to answer a question, we have a brand new resource for you, and it can be accessed in virtually any footer that we have at NCBI, even if they look a bit different. On the bottom right-hand corner, you'll see the link to the NCBI Support Center. The NCBI Support Center is a place where you can find discrete answers to important questions. Some of the questions are, can I get a subscription to access all the journals in PubMed through NCBI? How do I cite BLAST in my manuscript? How can I find all the protein sequences that belong to a specific protein family? How can I find a genome for my organism of interest? And a whole lot of more questions as well. If you still can't quite figure out the answer to your question, there is a link to write to the help desk on the top of the page, which will help create a help ticket for a member of our help desk to answer. We will do our best to answer the question and get right back to you within 2 working days. Often, you'll actually get a response quicker than that. Please note that we do not answer user help requests on our social media platforms, such as Twitter or Facebook, as the space limitations and postings prevents us from really being able to help as much as we need to. Also, we don't have the personnel to be able to monitor all the channels, so we really go through directly through the help desk link here. And yes, those of you who are familiar with it can still use the old NCBI help desk email address, which is funneled through our new system. And that email address is still info@ncbi.nlm.nih.gov. Now that's a lot of stuff and a lot of resources and sites to remember. Here's my cheat sheet for you, which really summarizes pretty much what I've talked about, hopefully in a helpful and a succinct way. I've created a JPEG version of this slide and have actually put it in the webinar's materials directory, which you can find on that Learn Webinars page. I hope this image, which you are welcome to print out, use, and distribute, may make it easier for you to figure out how to keep up with what's going on at NCBI and how to find help. We'll also send you a direct link for this particular graphic in a follow-up email after this webinar. Thank you for your attention, and I'll be happy to take any questions you might have.
Okay, thanks, Rana. There aren't any questions in the question spot at the moment. If you have any, please enter them. We'll leave the webinar open for a couple of minutes to see if we can collect any questions. Okay, I think that's it for today then. Thanks, everyone, for coming, and we'll see you next time.